Hello everybody on YouTube land, and here it is then, Frozen 2 review. Just before we get to Frozen 2 review, because I haven't seen it yet, I'm going to go meet the Mrs. and Michelle now. Frozen 1. What do I think of it? A very good animated movie from Disney. Entertaining, funny, good songs, Let It Go, etc. Very entertaining. It is a good family film, and especially around Christmas time, because obviously it's very snowy, etc. Out of 5, I go 4 stars. I really like it. I know it is overhyped, over the top, it's everywhere, you know, and it was a huge hit. But I really like it. I find it very enjoyable. Definitely worth the 4 stars. Check it out. After that, we have Frozen Fever. And it's a very short 7-minute music video, basically. And yeah, it's entertaining enough. Would I recommend it? Yeah. Out of 5, well, that got a 4. I'd say it's a 3.75. It's very short, so it's very difficult to judge something so short. But for what it is, it's entertaining, 3.75, worth a watch. And then you've got the 21 minutes and a special Olaf's Frozen Adventure. It went Iceland's. And yeah, this is an entertaining follow-up. Again, it's about the same league as the previous one, 3.75. Very entertaining, some nice songs. And it actually has my favourite song from the Frozen franchise to date, which is When We're Together. So very nice song. And yeah, it's entertaining. It's worth a watch, definitely, if you like Frozen movies. So there we go. That's all the Frozen stuff that's been released up until now. Frozen 2, just going to head off now. Let's go and see Frozen 2 with the missus and our friend Michelle. And we're home, people. I've just been to see Frozen 2. What's it like? What's the story? I don't really know. it's a few years later from the first one, and Elsa's hearing a sound from a mysterious village, woods, forest, and she goes to see what's going on. And the gang follow her, obviously. And I can't go into much more spoilers, you know. So, is it any good? For the most part, yeah. I thought it was beautifully animated. The songs were fine. Not as good as Let It Go or any of the rest of them. They're not as memorable, but they are good. They're not bad. The pacing's a bit slow here and there, but it's quite long, but I'm getting the negatives out of the way. I did find that the second half dragged a little bit at times. But I need to see it again, I think. It wasn't a very good experience at the cinema tonight. But I think overall it's a good film. It's not as good as the first. That is quite easy to say. And it was never going to be. It's something that big, that phenomenon, whatever you want to call it. Somebody's listening to the soundtrack already. I wonder who that is. So yeah, the story's alright. a bit anticlimactic. Again, it's fine. There's nothing really wrong with it. It's just nothing out of the norm. But I really enjoyed it. I saw the nakers out of the way. What's good? Like I said, the music's good. The voice work is good. The comedy at times is spot on. Really funny. Olaf is really funny in here. I think he's funnier than he was in the first one, personally. You believe in the two sisters, Anna and Elsa. They really do work well together. And when they're together, the film really works. In fact, as a unit, they're all together. It really works really well. Like I said, the first half I found to be better paced than the second half. But I found, like I said, the experience of watching it wasn't that great. I'm not going to go into it, but to say it was very noisy. But they would expect. But it was good. It was a good film. It could have gone a couple of other ways, which I think they should have done, but they didn't. But overall, I said, it's pretty good. It's worth a watch, definitely. And take the kids, they'll love it. Yes. This is a bit of a hokey-cokey review. I guess it's because I need to see it again. I'm just giving you my first reaction. And because my experience wasn't that great, it's going to kind of knock my opinion on it a little bit, which is unfair on the film, so which is why I'm giving this a temporary rating. It may go up, it may go down, but I will be seeing it again, definitely. I know the wife wants to go and see it again, so I'll be going to see it with her. She really enjoyed it, and our friend Michelle really enjoyed it, and I really enjoyed it for what I could make of it. So I might as well tell you what happened. Why was it a bad experience? Well, there was a woman sat next to me, and she had one of those tango blast things, and so I heard all the way through it, and towards the end she started scraping the bottom of this bloody cup, and it got annoying. The kids behind us kept farting, and people kept getting in and out. The kids are getting restless. Like I said, it's a more of a mature film than the first one, as in it's got some more adult themes, or it's got more, it's not as kid friendly. Definitely not as kid friendly. So there, even though Olaf is funny, it was a bit more mature. So I guess because it's 6 years later, the audience that watched it as a kid have grown up as well. So I think it's a very good film. So like I said, the experience wasn't great. There was other things as well, like people talking, and it's what you come to expect, isn't it? When you go see a film like this on opening night that's big and it's full of kids, it's going to be noisy. So me and the wife are going to check it out when it's died down again, and I will do a sort of short re-review, sort of for a vlog or something. So yeah, I'm sorry that this review is a bit whole hickety-pickety. It's just the way it is for tonight. So out of 5, like I said, I gave Frozen 1-4 stars, and I gave the two shorts 3.75. I think it's in the same league as the two shorts, so 3.75 out of 5. That's a good score. That's, you know, it's about 7.5 out of 10. So it is a good film, and I need to rewatch it, and I will rewatch it, and I will let you know what I think of it after seeing it again. But as it stands at this moment in time, 3.75, good film. And I said, despite all my negativity I've said about it, I really did enjoy it. And I would recommend it, definitely. So thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. It means the world to me if you do. Take care, everybody. And I guess I'm just going to have to, you know, it's coming, don't you? Let it go.